Hello, everyone. I am Ashish Podar, and I'm a program manager with Microsoft Edge. Today, I'm going to talk about developing and managing extensions. I'll start with a quick recap of Edge extensions and what we covered in last Ignite, and then I'm going to talk about managing extensions in your enterprise. I'll also talk about publishing extensions as an enterprise, and I'll share a few things about our product roadmap and how can you reach out in case you need some help or more information about extensions. Let's go with a quick recap. So just to let you know, there's no registration fee for registering and submitting extensions. Chromium extensions are compatible with Edge. You can port your Chrome extensions very easily. And you can contact us through several options that I'm going to list down today. And we have an extensive email support to address your queries. One key thing that I want to tell you today is that we already have 5,000 plus extensions on the store. And 70% of extension installs on Microsoft Edge come from the Microsoft Edge Add-ons website. Isn't that exciting? As a next step, I also want to talk about the extensive review process that we have for extensions. Every extension that's uploaded to the Microsoft Edge Add-ons store goes through a pre-approval process. Extensions with high-risk permissions also go through a code review. There's a well-defined process to investigate incidents, and we have a 30-minute SLA to disable malicious extensions. We continue to make more improvements to help ensure that Microsoft Edge add-ons are trusted, reputable, and safe for our users. And finally, we have enterprise policies that help you manage extensions in your organizations. I'm now going to talk about managing extensions in your enterprise. There are several options available to manage extensions in your enterprise. There are powerful policies like extension settings, and we're also going to publish a detailed document about managing extensions in your enterprise, and I'll be sharing the links on the next slide. You can also force install Chrome extensions, and there are all the policies that work for Microsoft Edge add-ons also work for Chrome extensions. Finally, you can also set your own premise store, and the link for that is also going to be shared in the next slide. Microsoft Edge provides the power to manage extensions in your enterprise. You can control which extensions can be installed in your enterprise. You can block external extensions. You can block extensions that use a high-risk permission. You can control which websites hosts extension have access to. That's very, very helpful if you want to restrict extensions from accessing some websites which have data which is crucial to your organization. You can block all extensions and allow only specific extensions to be installed. You can use the allow list policy to decide which extensions will be allowed in your enterprise. Or you can choose to just block specific extensions and let everybody install the rest of the extensions that they want. And we've also seen organizations use the force install policy to install extensions to all their users or to some security groups. There's one new feature that we've recently tested based on the feedback from administrators, and now you can block extensions from third-party stores. For example, in the slide, you'll see how to block the extensions just from Chrome Web Store. This is a new feature that's available now for you to test and give us feedback. These are the links to the new documentation that's soon going to be available to you. Akka.ms, getting ready to manage extensions. This document will help you prepare for managing extensions in your organizations and covers the basic around installing ADMX and group policy editors. The second link here, Akka.ms extension group policies, covers the policies available with a few examples that will help you understand how you can manage extensions in your enterprise. Finally, the document akka.ms enterprise store would help you guide how to set up your own enterprise store. Now I'll go into a demo to help you register your enterprise so that you can submit extensions. This is the first step to help developers in your organization publish extensions. And we're going to cover a few basics here just to help you out with the registration process. First and most important, Partner Center is the way for you to submit extensions to the Microsoft Edge add-ons website. To log into the Partner Center, your organization must have a Microsoft account. And then you will have to register into the Microsoft Edge add-ons program Now, at the moment, you're required to have an MSA account to register for Microsoft Edge Add-ons program. In future, we're looking to allow you to register using your work accounts directly. The next step after you have logged into the Partner Center and registered for the Microsoft Edge Add-ons program is to add your AD tenant in and link that to your MSA account. For that, you need to go to the Partner Center, go to Settings, go to Organizational Profile, and go to Tenants, and click Associate Azure AD with your Partner Center account, and follow the steps thereafter to link your AD account to your MSA account. After the linking is done, you can give access to users within your organization to access the Partner Center on behalf of your organization and submit extensions. To give access to users within your organization, visit the Partner Center account settings and then go to User Management and click the Add User button and follow the steps thereafter to add as many users you want. Those were the steps for you to follow to help developers in your organization publish extensions on behalf of your organization. Now, one more thing. If your organization is already enrolled into an existing program on the Partner Center, what should you be doing? If you follow the Partner Center link to Microsoft Edge add-ons, you may see an error if you're logged in with your AD account. In that case, it means that your organization is not yet registered for the Microsoft Edge add-ons program. And to register, you need to go log in with the Microsoft owner account associated with your work account and register for the Edge add-ons program and follow the steps that we covered in the previous chapter. Next, I'm going to share the roadmap for Edge extensions. There are two key features that are coming in future and that you should be looking forward to. We're looking to provide quick access to Microsoft Edge program for enterprise users already enrolled into the Windows program. The key here is once this feature rolls out, you will not have to depend on the MSA account to enroll into the program. You will be able to enroll directly from the Windows program. And secondly, we are also looking to make available APIs so that you can publish and update Edge extensions and integrate seamlessly the whole publishing process into your CI/CD pipeline. Finally, here's some more documentation that'll help you if you're looking for any guidance. Number one, there's extensive documentation to help you publish your extension to the Microsoft Edge add-on store. Then there is this link for the Partner Center dashboard that's very handy if you're trying to register for the Microsoft Edge add-ons program or if you're trying to log in, come back and log in again. And then as I mentioned, there's contact us link here and there are several options for us to reach out whether you have an issue related to certification or you have a query related to development. Feel free to reach out using the various methods listed out on this page. Thank you so much. Thank you for joining us today. And we look forward to having all of your extensions on our Edge add-on store. Thank you.